When I stated the definition of the complexity class RP, I said that if a word is in the language, our Turing machine has to accept with a probability of least one half. But why did we pick one half as the threshold? Why not say it has to accept with a probability of at least one third, or two thirds, or one quarter, or three quarters? The number one half here seems somewhat arbitrary. And as it turns out, it really is arbitrary. You can plug in any other constant that is larger than zero, and you would get exactly the same complexity class. It would not change the complexity class at all. This is a good thing, because imagine you have a boss, and you go to your boss, and you say, I can solve our problem, well, I can solve it sort of. If the word is not in the language, we will detect that and reject for sure. But we will have some false negatives. So sometimes when the word is in the language, so the answer should be yes, we will really report no. And you say this might happen with a probability of one half. So half the time when the answer should be yes, we're really reporting no. Probably your boss would not be so happy. But if you say that this only happens 0.001% of the time, then maybe that is more acceptable. So in many cases, we really want to get this error probability much smaller than one half. And what we are now going to discuss is a trick on how you can achieve this. And this is known as probability amplification. Let's say we have a probabilistic Turing machine that rejects words that are not in the language for sure, and it accepts words that are in the language with probability at least one half. How could we turn such a probabilistic Turing machine with these properties into one that still rejects every word that is not in the language, but accepts words that are in the language with a much larger probability? Again, maybe pause for a minute and think about this. It's not too hard, at least once you see the solution, I think it will be quite easy, but try to come up with it yourself for a minute. The answer is that we can simply run our probabilistic Turing machine several times. So say you run the probabilistic Turing machine twice. If a word is not in the language, what is the probability that that Turing machine will reject the word both times? Well, the probability for that is equal to 1, because we know that if a word is not in the language, the probabilistic Turing machine will reject for sure, so it will do this both times. Now, if the word is in the language, what is the probability that the Turing machine will reject both times? So the probability that the Turing machine will reject the first time is at most one half, and the probability that the Turing machine will reject the second time is also at most one half. And these are independent random experiments. So the probability that it will reject both times is simply one half squared, which is just one quarter. So here is our new machine. The machine will simulate the probabilistic Turing machine we had before twice. If both times the result is reject, then we reject. But if at least one of the times the probabilistic Turing machine accepts, then our new machine also accepts. And this new machine will reject every word that is not in the language by the reasoning we had before, and it will accept a word that is in the language with probability at least three quarters. It will only be wrong one quarter of the time at most. Of course, we can extend this principle and we can reduce the error even more by running this probabilistic Turing machine we had before several times, not just twice, but three times, four times, five times, however many times you like. The more you run it, the less the probability that you make a mistake. And the general principle just remains the same. You run the machine, say, k times in total. If it rejects every single time, you reject. If it accepts just a single time, you accept. And by doing this, because all of these k runs are independent random experiments, the probability that you accept the word that is in the language now increased to at least 1 minus 1 over 2 to the k, while the probability that you reject a word that is not in the language remains equal to 1. So we reduce the error greatly, and we can choose k to be quite large. We just have to be careful that the machine we get is still running in polynomial time. So k needs to be polynomial in the size of the input. But as long as that is the case, we can run the machine many, many times and reduce the error greatly, because the error probability really decreases exponentially as we increase k.